your first run. Let's try it again. I want the gold because we did the shop here. Or I go through the middle here. There's a lot of campfires. We take the rare card and build around it. All for one? I guess it's the same. But maybe this time I focus more on it. Oh dear. Cast it so we can just kill him. Yes. Yeah, one cost dual cast makes this early fighting so much easier. Yeah, beam cell, absolutely. Early shop. There's no other shop coming. Probably take the auto shields again. One of those is always nice to have. The hologram is probably better here. What are we doing? Just need to upgrade it. Zero cost cards yet. Get any back. The fragment is still good if I take a few frost orbs for defense. Now we streamline. The boss line. Let's go with the defragment. First upgrade hologram, otherwise it's a useless card. Kill this guy. Lock. Potion. Chill is rather useful. Block. Electronics charm. 4 damage is still enough to kill him. You go for this guy. the Alpha 1 back. Enough cheap cards. At least I'm not taking damage, I mean. Well, I'm hoping for. Redo, stack, turbo. If I upgrade it, the Rito is a zero cost card as well. So that's pretty neat. Let's do that. I do want to upgrade this first, the fragment. And then Rito and Seth want to be upgraded as well. Get an additional 15 HP when you rest. This. Doesn't matter what I take back. Just played. That's four, yeah, I need one defend. Yeah, I want to do the cast block instead of lightning here. But yeah, enough defense. Do not take damage. Now let's expel. Team damage. I can't kill him. Case. At least a little bit more block thanks to the fragment. Double energy. Getting a lot of zero cost cards. Not particularly a fan of it. Just the sweeping beam. Redo hologram. All for one. For one this guy. Redo. Second redo wasn't necessary. I can't target the rest, so. Okay. 9. And this. It's 5 damage, so I can't kill him. Glacier. Absolutely. Defense value. Let's break the sap. All about the zero cost. Oh no. Play this. 13 block. Or I kill those two. Take 10 less damage. They're dead. I mean, I'm getting weakened anyway. Probably best to take 3 more damage. Kill 2 of them off. Can't take any more damage after that. Is to redo. I think I'm going to rest. Make this safer. Maybe I can get a good split with the bomb. Glacier back. Let's do that. I want to cycle the dark though. I can sacred back to the front. Hang on, if I play the Sap, he's going to split, isn't he? I'm gonna do that. To redo or the dual cast to get it to the front. Play the glacier. Same problem. I mean, I guess I still get a good split. Yeah, we can all for one into Sap into dual cast. It's pretty much the dream. Get this to the front and kill the guy. That's pretty neat. I think I need that many artifact potions. Another all for one, absolutely. No energy relic. Can't take Snake Eye. Well, I mean, I don't draw my normal zero cost card, but I could redraw Neko's zero cost card. Well, the question is that worth it? Probably not. Question is inserter or battery then. Try the inserter again. Take this path. Mostly through the middle. use potion. Front and then redo gel for extra damage, and then you should die. And upgraded leap. It's 12 o'clock, that's not too bad. Ooh, Ashra. Claw. Mushra. Cool. Finesse would have been okay too. Let's remove. Can get back the all for one. The claw redo for more block. I don't take damage either. Yeah, that's rainbow. That's an extra block. And the dark orb. Should just die here. Yeah, great here. Swan. I think I'm going to skip here. Could use another claw or something like that. For one. No defense. Let's get the leap back. One wouldn't have given me too much damage here. I skipped it. In favor of defense. I could redo the dark here. That's probably a good idea. Nice damage on the guy. A lot of block this way too. Ooh, chill plus. Also go for the eyes. I like both of those. If it wasn't upgraded, I would go for the eyes. I think it's still better. I'm getting it back a few times. Wanna create this. Keeping Weeb up the enemies. Pretty valuable. Oh, it's another all for one. And the mind blast. I'm a poor guy. Let's form a card. Ooh, got a seek out of that. That's nice. If you end your turn without block, gain 6 block. Nice. I was looking for something else there. For the eyes on him. He should die soon. Redo. Keep him weakened as well. 8. I can block damage. Seek here. Let's get all the stuff back. Oh, lightning kills him. Can always kill him with go for the eyes. And I need some block value. Taken either. Oh, I could have just killed him with the fragment, probably. Oh. No, either way, hologram or for one rainbow. Be nice. I mean, barrage could be nice too. Hey there, Avenger. Seems like it's going good for you. Barrage would be a lot of damage. Cold Snap would give me another Frost Orb. Like both here. Do I need to upgrade? Need to upgrade Claw. Any upgrades to have? One, maybe two. Yeah, boss fights was. But. Barrage is nice damage in boss fight, but in boss fights I have a lot of frost orbs, so I evoke them as cold snap, so that's pretty good too. I think I need to upgrade the barrage to make it really useful, while cold snap is useful right away. That's why I'm checking my upgrades. I'm gonna upgrade Claw. Beam Cell would be nice. Might sneak in barrage. Yeah, let's get defragment. my glacier. Sails out. Sell back the one the block longer. Much damage, that's 4 28. Go first. Ooh, but rainbow would be nice too. No. Get him low. And the lightning strikes. Perfect targeting. Ascender Spain, when you have Ascension 10, I think, you start the run, each run cursed, and that's the curse you get. So, yeah, you kind of remove it, but it is easier, so it gets removed when you don't discard the one fight you have. I think I'm taking the Impulse here. I don't think another barrage is what's needed here. There's another beam cell here. Or another hologram. Guess it could be worse. Yeah. Well, for a time, for a short time, you couldn't remove it and it wasn't Etheria. So, that was bad. Tempted to take the hologram and upgrade it right away. Another beam cell would be nice too. Let's take hologram. It also lets me get back my glacier if needed. It's such a flexible card. No gold to get jaxed. I mean, I have only one claw, it won't stack up too much for damage. I think upgrading barrage or impulse is better here. What's the max floor in this game? There's 3 maps. So 51? 52? Something like that. I don't know the exact number. So this is the second map, and then if I beat the boss, which I'm not sure, I only have 3 energy instead of 4. I'm upgrading impulse for the boss fight. Glacier out. Let's start some damage on this guy. Shorter than you thought. Oh, still takes some time. Let's get the rainbow in there. Still seek and one all for one. The all for one back first, I think. 28 damage, or I could use the impulse. Wait, I don't take damage and the dark stacks up. Electronics turn. Solar cramps. Let's use the impulse. In the wrong targets. Prepare his big attack, I believe. Redo and dual cast the bomb. Move them dead. Where did you get Claw and where can you get more? Got it from a random fight. It's just a normal rare card, you can buy it in the shop or on random card rewards. Since it's a rare card, it's hard to find. I only had the chance to pick up one this run. I wish I'd go for the eyes here. He still has his artifacts, I guess it doesn't matter. I have to play Glacier. It's not too bad for a Hyper Beam turn. Seems really good. Imagine just having 3 to 4. Yeah, if you get multiple, it's really good. But that's the problem. But that's why it's also good with the all for one, because I can draw it more often. Healing's 32 damage I get. If I play impulse, I get enough. Or I could get an all for one back for a lot of damage. Could weaken him this way. Still take some damage. That would deal more to him. I think that's fair. Ah, I might not even take damage with the redo. The blade is smart. I have to remove artifact so I can weaken him. That's 24 damage. And then redo the frost orb for block. Yeah, and then I should be fine this turn. Nothing to seek this turn. I don't want to draw that next turn. And attention need block next turn, that's why I drew some attack cards and get out of the way. He's dealing 40 damage. Which damage good idea. And he's doing 40 damage. I'm blocking 12. And I'm surviving if I play this. All for one. How much damage is that? 49. I could hologram the invoke. Game could have tons of replayability with mods, more enemies and cards. Yeah. But I mean, they're adding more and more stuff from the developer side as well. And there are already some mods. There are some characters. I haven't tried any of those, but I've seen others play them. I could hologram the impulse, I guess. And defense here. Hologram another. Go for the eyes. Yeah, I did no damage at all. That's even better. But I would take 2 or 4 damage. And then we kill him. Okay. Too expensive. Upgrade fusion could be okay. I'm never going to play a meteor, that's way too expensive with 3 energy. I'm hoping I get an energy relic here, so I skip. Well, I mean, there's cards that give you temporary mana. There's the Snecko Eye, which randomizes the cost of cards. You could have Plasma Orbs, which give you energy. Yeah, I need the energy so soon. 4 energy now. Can no longer obtain potions. But I haven't played Meteor outside of Snecko Eye yet. But with Snecko Eye it's a little bit too good, I would say. But on the net, yeah, it's probably hard to play. Too unreliable. 3. Who's the boss? Awakened one. Interesting. No Time Eater this time, despite me having an all-for-one build. It's one guy dead. Where am I from? Sensing Eastern European vibe. Europe is correct. East, not so much. From Germany. Let's get the all for one back. I got a block so I can deal some damage to this guy. Blocking enough. Time for another all for one round. And yeah, I can claw him once without taking damage. And let the lightning do its job. Another impulse. Yeah. Once I have my orbs up, impulse is pretty good. Yeah, let's fight. Let's see how good the deck is. But first off, let's sweeten this guy. This out. Yeah, it's decent first turn. Not perfect. What could I get back? It's the impulse, hologram, impulse. Oh, out of energy. It's really misplay. Get the dark orb to the front, I'm killing someone. Ooh, I can play Azure and then dual cast. Right, I still had a free orb slot. It's 13. Dead. One guy dead. He's worrying me. Just getting out of hand. It's a weak potion. Hang on, I can seek to redo. All for one and basically kill them all. We do all for one. We do all for one. Yeah, I mean. That's true. But the left one is harder to kill for me because he has Zorn's damage. It was good that the orb killed him. Energy is now conserved between turn. The dream would have been obviously dual cast the Shadow Orb. But yeah. Ooh, FTL and Beam Cell. My name is FTL. See you later. Oh, Michigan, US. It's still early for you, right? Always get the times confused. Yeah, it should be early for you. That's only a little one. Mind Blast is nice here, I think. I do debuff them sometimes with go for the eyes and the beam cell. Let's try the card. With some decent damage as well. Which cards? Question is which is more damage. Damage from my draw pile, so when I use it with all for one, the mind plus down gets too much value. As most of the cards should be in my discard. At least for the later ones. Take the nature. Maybe it's a little bit less damage, but I get the cards that I want more often. And it's more reliable compared to Mind Blast. not visiting another shop. Unless I find a random one. Oh. And the polochrome, go for the eyes. All decent options here. What should we upgrade? But a few cards I want to upgrade, so holochrome maybe not the best choice. Let's go to Pendant. As I take the Madness, it gives me more zero cost cards I can redraw with the All for One. I mean, it's not ideal because it delays my setup. We still... I mean, one Madness maybe, but two... Maybe a bit too much... ...for damage. Let's upgrade this. Keep the vulnerable up. That's one sad kill. At least he's dead. Okay, now we got some damage as well. Let's kill this one, redraw a lot of stuff. And defend Madness, doing some. Value. The chill. And see, lightning did hit him. I can debuff this guy instead. And we have enough block up now. That's wrong. All for one. Yeah. Ryu doesn't get to do anything here. At least he dies. I think a potion would have been nice. Not a new reprieve. Would help in the boss fight? Probably not. I think I'm skipping it here. I see. I mean, completely. If I play the defend first. Chance I get hologram and offer one for cheaper. Nice. Why am I drawing cards when I play offer one? Oh, right, I'm infinite. Offer one draws hologram. Hologram this all for one. I didn't even see that coming. But I don't think I can set that up reliably. Oh, maybe I can. Could try. Yeah, hi there, Sildrium. But I have to madness the two correct targets, so that's unlikely to happen in most fights, I would say. I guess one reprieve. Gold 10% more likely to find treasure in question mark rooms. Where's the way to make this more likely to happen again? Not really. I mean, with the Seek I can get Madness and either All for One or Hologram setup. The upgrade on a 3 card. No. Not helping. If you do not play any attacks during your turn, gain an extra energy next turn. Not the deck for that. In here, I can kill him with a cheaper card. Go infinite again, I think. I can't attack that often. It hit the wrong target. It's the hologram. Could have gone infinite again. I hate those guys. I guess I can just wait them out most likely. And they deal 18 damage, that's 4. So we can attack once. Get the darkness to the front. And dual cast it. Nope. Good here. I want to upgrade the barrage. Might rest here in case I find something better. Remove a card. Even better. Create the barrage. All for one. I do need some block though. Where's my glacier? First, and then make the offer one free. I don't miss one of those fast. One block here. And the second madness just needs to get the hologram or another all for one for zero, right? Then I'm infinite again. Should be possible to do. The weakness on him. Hey. Just can't hit FTL. Rid of this. Rid of this. Madness the all for one. And I should be infinite. Couldn't play the Zeps, right? Because when he reawakens. Yeah, I might. Hang on. Do I want to kill him here? I'm not drawing the correct cards. I should have thought this through. D4 damage this turn at 16. I'm killing him this turn. I'm reshuffling anyway. It's my fear. If I didn't get more block up or had the card from last turn, he might have straight up killed me. I need to cycle and until I find the other FTL again. Not FTL, one for one. Yeah, that's why I shouldn't have played the saps, because if I had all the frost orbs, there wouldn't be any risk here. Now there is. Survive this turn, right? Question is if I want to draw the FTL first to draw another card. Or just need to survive this turn. Might be able to kill him here if I go for all attacks, but I guaranteed survive this turn. If I survive the turn, I kill him. Slime infinite. Considering I was infinite early on, so the possibility to lose there. Yeah, that was Ascension 14. But no. Made it all the way.